Thank you. Well, as Ron mentioned, I'm a pediatrician. I work at Seattle Children's and at University of Washington, and I did my Master's of Public Health here at UW. So a lot of my time is spent doing research and public health research. I'm also the mom of two boys, 6 and 9 year old, which really have inspired and continue to inspire and make this work very relevant to me personally and professionally. So I'm going to start with talking about the epidemic of physical inactivity that's in our country. You know, we often talk about the obesity epidemic. Yeah. I'll move on to the next slide. We often talk about the obesity epidemic, and that's obviously a very important reason for people to be active. But there's actually, independent of obesity, so whether you're overweight or not, being active as a child and as an adult has important implications for your health and well-being. And here, we sort of see that, you know, how active you are as a child not only impacts your health now. Health, when I say health, I mean that in the broadest sense. Your physical health, your psychological health, and overall sense of well-being. And it also affects how confident you feel engaging in physical activity. That could affect your activity later on in life. It could affect how much joy you feel and how healthy you are to be able to continue a life of physical activity. And all of those things are going to impact how active you are as an adult. So for me, you know, starting at the very youngest ages, I focus a lot of my work on the early childhood years, the 3, 4, and 5 year olds, is critical for their health status now and really for the rest of their lives. Ron alluded to this a little bit. I mean, why are we all less active than maybe previous generations? Well, there have been dramatic changes to our landscape. Very few of us live in places like this, or children that can kind of run around through hills and fields. And we're either living in suburban areas that were designed for cars and don't give us very many places to walk to or parks to play in, or we live in urban areas that may not have safe sidewalks or places where our family feels safe sending our children to go play and spend time. Arguably, there's also been changes in our lifestyles and what children do with their time. They may spend a lot of time shuttling from place to place, and I think parents' work requirements and time that they're not with children certainly affects what children do in their time. There's the ever-present screen time from the youngest ages of, you know, and in all different forms. There are a lot of structured activities that children are getting into from younger and younger ages. And of course, the academic pressures. And as I mentioned, I work in the preschool age, and what we've seen happen to school-age children, we're cutting recess and PE, even though we know with convincing research that that does not boost test scores. Sadly, our early childhood educators are feeling the same pressure to sort of cut playtime to focus on kindergarten readiness and early learning from that standpoint. One study I did a few years ago, we looked at nationally representative data, so over 8,000 parents of preschoolers, so 4 and 5 year olds, were asked, how often do you take your child to play outdoors? So again, these are preschoolers, and the highest bar there, 41% said few times a week, and you know, if you add up the few times a month and rarely and not at all, you easily get above half. So less than half of parents of preschoolers themselves are taking their preschooler to play outside every day. Not surprising, I'm not with my preschooler at this moment in time, and lots of other parents are not with their child during their peak awake daytime hours that they can take them outside. So I think that we have to rely a lot on other adults and other settings where children spend time. And that's become my focus in the last several years. The majority of children in this age group spend considerable time, you know, not in the care of their parents. Some of the research I've done and others have done has shown that a lot of that time is sedentary, sadly. And our states have some, our policies have room to improve as far as getting kids more active. We looked at a survey of Washington State a few years ago and found that while most childcare centers and home met the minimum standards, less than a quarter met best practices as far as physical activity and outdoor time. And outdoor time is really important. It's one of the most consistent correlates of physical activity and certainly all of the other benefits of being outdoors and in nature for children. Some of my work involves putting activity meters to measure how much kids are, how much their hips are moving, and that tells us how active they are, and GPS devices that they happily wear tell us if they're indoors and outdoors, and we can see where they're active and how active they're getting. And one study we did, we found that in childcare, when you add up their nap time and their not active play time, 88% of their day was not an opportunity for physical activity. And these things are having an impact on children's health and well-being. And certainly, as we think about what early learning is and what really learning is for all children, it's become my interest and focus in thinking about how physical activity can play a role in children's overall health and learning and throughout their years. And I will stop there. Thank you.